All right, hey guys, Tony Maritato here. So I'm gonna follow up on Damon's video about crossing your legs. He did an awesome job. I love his tip about, let's say it was my right knee that was replaced. Let's say I have at least 90 degrees of flexion, maybe more. And for whatever reason, maybe I wanna get to my shoe, maybe I wanna clip my toenails, for whatever reason, if I wanna get that leg across, but I can't, most of the limitation after you've been past 90 degrees, you know, ideally you'd be closer to 100, 110 degrees of flexion. Most of the limitation is really going to come from the hip and the rotation you have in the hip joint. So, like Damon said, you can start just kind of crossing the feet, see how that feels. You could grab your pant leg, you can grab your sock, you can start to bring that up. I always like to ask my patients to kind of give the knee some support at the outside, because if you, like me, have tightness through the hip, what happens in this position is my hip joint is actually pushing my femur down while the opposite leg is pushing my tibia up. So we create this, what we call a shear force, a force kind of pulling the knee apart laterally sideways, which the knee doesn't like to do. So I always say, you know, just give it a little support, kind of give it a hug, make it secure. This is a great position just to sit in and stretch. But let's say you're not there yet. Let's say you're looking for some way to get there. One of my favorite ways to work on it is on a couch, standard couch at home. I turn, I can use the backrest of the couch if I feel like I want some lumbar support, if I have some issues with spinal stenosis or other arthritic degenerative conditions. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bring the surgical side up into position. Now, a lot of times if you've had surgery on one leg, the other leg probably isn't that great either. So maybe this position for the non-surgical leg isn't doable. No big deal. Just let it hang out there. The surgical side, I'm nowhere near 90 degrees of knee flexion at this point. So what I'll do is I'll help by bringing the foot in. What I like about the couch is that it's got this crease between the cushions. So that gives me a perpendicular line so I can kind of line my leg up with my torso, with my body. I'm about 90 degrees at the knee. Hopefully you have more than 90 degrees of flexion, but if you don't, you can just stay shy of that 90 degrees. But really, in order to cross your legs in a normal kind of cross-legged sitting position, you probably need to get to at least 90, 100, and 110 degrees of flexion before you can even get to this position anyway. But that being said, so non-surgical leg out in front, surgical leg bent, my shin bone is kind of laying sideways in the crease of the cushion. From here, nice and tall through the spine, I lean forward. If, you know, you feel comfortable with this, we'll typically recommend you hold it 30 seconds to a minute. I like longer stretches. I like to spend time in the position. I'll typically cue my patients to stay straight through the spine, but there are times, and there's benefit to allowing the spine to flex and to bend. We know conditions like spinal stenosis respond positively to more of a lumbar, rounded lumbar curve. So whatever is comfortable for you, whatever your physical therapist advises, that's what you're looking for. I'll lean forward. I might turn toward the surgical knee. I'll typically line the center of my torso with the center of my knee, 30 seconds to a minute. And then just like we always do, we want to stay symmetrical. So I'll turn to the other side, let my surgical leg hang out, bring my non-surgical leg into a 90 degree knee bend, straight spine, flex spine if it's recommended. I'll turn toward the knee. I'm basically looking for the restriction. Everybody's gonna be tight in a little different area, so you're trying to find where your tightness is, and then just spend a little time into it. Discomfort is okay, but pain is not necessary. We're trying to find that balance, 30 seconds to a minute. Now, here's the disclaimer. I've never met you. I've never assessed or evaluated you. This isn't a recommendation for you. What this is education. This is information for you to take back to your physical therapist and start a discussion about, hey, I want to do this. How can I do this? Is it safe for me to do this? What are your recommendations? I saw this online and I want to know if this is right for me. This is a conversation starter. That's all it is. Guys, I love helping you. If you have questions, post them in the comments. If you take a minute, subscribe to the channel, turn on the notification bell. The more people that subscribe, the more people we can reach and provide useful information. As always, I appreciate you being here and I'll catch you in the next video. Thanks for watching.